Hello everybody, today I am going to be doing a drugstore makeup look, something that I would probably wear every single day. I did just get this in the post. I did an order on Beauty Bay last night and it came this morning. So I ordered a new Mario Badescu facial spray, because this is my old one. I've literally got barely any left, and I think it's so nice to prep your skin with. So I just got a new one of those, and I just bought the new Morphe 3502. So I do have two Morphe palettes. Anyways, I have the Morphe 12NB, which is a neutral one, and it has a 35T, which is taupes and purples, so that's the one that I have there. But this one is the 35O, but it's a second nature, that's what it's called. Oh, they've changed their packaging, look at that. Okay, so oh, and they have names, that's so good. Okay, and it's so beautiful. Honestly, I've never seen a palette that is so, like, so much up my alley than that one. And I know it's not like properly drugstore, like it's not in, like, but it's a palette that is for 35 shades, and I think it was 20 something pounds. It was 20 something pounds, and it was like, let's find out how much it was. £23 for 35 colours, and I think that is so affordable. And the pigment that you get off of them is just insane. So yeah, I'm gonna use that today, and everything else I'll use is gonna be like properly drugstore as well. Or like high street. Anyway, let's get on with the video. So for foundation, I'm gonna be using the Rimmel London Lasting Perfection, no, Rimmel London Lasting Finish 25 hour skin perfecting full coverage foundation in the shade 100, which is ivory. Now I think this might be a little bit too, it's a bit too pink for me, but it is such a nice foundation. I'm just going to adjust my mirror. It's such a nice foundation. It has really good coverage, and yeah. The only thing I'd say about it is that it smells like paint, which is one of the only things that I find like I would definitely change about this foundation, is that it does smell a bit like paint, which obviously I'm not a massive fan of, because it's just a bit chemically. But yeah, just apply that like that, and then I'm going to use my Real Techniques beauty sponge and just blend that in. Done. It's not insanely like full coverage, but it gives you enough coverage that it's so like skin like it's really pretty. Okay, so on to concealer. I am going to use the Collection Lasting Perfection concealer in the shade 0, which is Extra Fair. It's a new shade and I'm so glad they brought out a new one, because it actually works so well. This one compared to Fair, because Fair's a bit too dark for my under eyes, but it works really well for like my spots and stuff like that. Because obviously my skin is not the greatest at the moment. Another concealer that I'd like to give a little shout out to is the Makeup Revolution Conceal and Define. It is such a full coverage concealer. It's so good. I'm the shade C1. And I'm so sad. I literally just ran out of it. I think I still got a little bit left, so I'll just pop that here. It is so full coverage and so good for your under eyes and highlighting. And I've seen some people use like the darker shades for contour and stuff like that. I'm just applying the extra fur over the top there. So this combination I found worked so well for me because the Collection concealer does give coverage but not as much as I'd like for under my eyes, because I do get quite dark circles under my eyes. So I just find that applying the Revolution over like the darkest patches on the inner corners gives the right amount of coverage. I do find that you have to work quite quickly with the Collection concealer, just because it just set quite easily, like it sets down quite quickly. I'm gonna set my under eyes quickly with the Rimmel Match Perfection loose powder in the shade Transparent. I'm just gonna set that before I do the rest of my highlighting, just because my eyes crease like mad, so I need to set this before I do anything else really. Just highlight the rest of my face and blend that in. Now I'm just going to spot conceal with the shade 1. I'm going to put that on the back of my hand and then apply it with my finger to my spots rather than like contaminating the product inside. Again with that same powder. But then I like to use a set powder for the rest of my face. So I'm just going to use the Rimmel Stay Matte Powder in Transparent. And then swirl my brush in it. So I'm going to use my Rimmel Radiance Brick in shade 2 Medium, just like that. It's a bit shimmery, and then I'm going to use the Body Shop Honey Bronze in the shade 4, it just looks like that. I like to use two bronzers just because I like to have like the set matte bronzer down first just to create more depth, and then I like to go in with a shimmer bronzer just to add that healthy glow back into the skin. Obviously you don't have to use both a matte and a shimmer bronzer. If you don't want, you can just use the matte bronzer or just the shimmer bronzer. Depends what you like. Well, then I'm gonna go in with the Radiance Brick on a New Techniques blush brush. And I just like to stipple that over the bronzer. I don't put too much of this on just because I don't like too much shimmer on my bronzer points, but I do think it looks really healthy and nice to just have that bit of shimmer over the top, especially on the forehead. I prefer to have it on the forehead than I do the cheek, and I just put a bit on the cheek anyways and then a bit on my nose. So now on bronze, I'm gonna do some blush, and I'm gonna go in with the Sleep Face Form Contouring Blush Palette in the shade Light, just with a unicorn fluffy brush. I'm really into like glowy skin at the moment, making my skin look as glowy as I can. Obviously I can't really do that with a foundation just because I do have oily skin, so if I do use a glowy foundation I am bound to just look like an oil slick like 2 to 5 hours later, really. Right, so now I'm gonna use the Mario Badescu facial spray just to put a bit more moisture back in my face. I like to use the aloe herbs and rose water one in comparison to the other one. I can't remember. The green one, the aloe vera one. The other aloe vera one. Yeah, I prefer to use the rose water one just because I love the smell of rose water. So nice. Okay, so I'm gonna go in with brows. Now I don't actually have a drugstore brow product, so I might just do my brows off camera quickly and come back to you. So I've done my brows. I used the Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade in dark brown. A good dupe for that would be the, it's not Freedom anymore, the Revolution Pro Brow Pomade. Hair. Yeah, the Revolution Brow Pomade is also very good. Other brow pomades will work quite similar, it's just that's the one that I got. I've also primed my eyes. I never use an eye primer, I just use a concealer, like a thick concealer. So let's crack on with the eyes into the 3502 palette. The only thing that I'm really scared of is getting makeup marks on the front. This is the palette. I'm not gonna do anything too extreme. I'm gonna take the color Universal, which is this guy right here. I'm gonna take that and pop that in the crease. Ooh. That pigmentation is nice. Okay, so that's that. I'm then gonna go in with the color Risky, which is a like mauvey browny color. There is a bit of kickback on this color, which I didn't get on the first one. A
there's some pigment. I think I just poked myself in the eyeball. Yeah, did just poke myself in the eye. This is what we got so far.
I'm then gonna say, I literally don't know what I'm doing with this, but it'll be fun. You go with the colour Heat.
Jeez, okay. Wow. This is so pretty.
That shade is so pretty. I'm then gonna go back in with that first colour that I used, the Universal. And just pop that just above that colour. Just a blend.
That's so pretty. I literally love this palette.
I'm gonna take the colour Brick on a little like tapered guy. Take that.
And then put that on the outer corner. A little bit of Rich just on that little outer bit. Oh, that colour is pretty.
That colour is pretty. I don't know what to put on the lid. Right, I'm gonna take the colour Sauce, which is a really pretty
orange shimmer, and we're gonna pack that on the lid.
Okay.
I might just spray my brush quickly, see if I can get some more pigment.
I'm gonna highlight my inner corner quickly with the shade Pure, which is a really, really pretty, like champagne-y color. Honestly, like for a first impression of that palette, so good. I'm gonna use a NYX Epic Ink liner. The only thing I find with this eyeliner, like, it does bleed quite a bit, so I always have to like get the excess ink off of this because it just smudges and it's just annoying sometimes, but I still use it.
That's eyeliner. Now we're gonna go in with mascara. For mascara, I'm gonna be using the Maybelline Lash Sensational Mascara, which is literally just an amazing mascara. It makes your lashes so full, so long, very pretty. Eyes with mascara. Like, I'm just gonna contour my schnoz a little bit. I just like to take a tapered brush and just put some bronzer down the side of my nose. Now we're going to do highlighter. I'll use the sleek one, and I'll just wet my brush. I've got hair on my nose again. I'm just going to wet my highlighter brush and go in with the sleek highlighter. I haven't even properly contoured. Dear me. Okay, taking the sleek face bronzer here. I'm just going to apply some brow gel. I'm using the Glossier Boy Brow, which obviously isn't drugstore. The Maybelline brow gel is really good. Anything with like a smaller brush is good, like something with a little like small brush like that, a little small spoolie. So I've just applied the NYX Soft Matte Lip Cream in the shade Abu Dhabi. I think it goes quite nicely with this look. I'm gonna do my hair and I'll be right back. Hey guys, so this is the finished look. I think it is so pretty. I love it. I'm very happy with how it turned out. Nice and grungy. Just what I like. If you like this video, then obviously please give it a thumbs up. Comment, subscribe to my channel. I do singing videos sometimes and makeup videos, holiday video things. So if that's what you like, then obviously subscribe. Make sure to click that little like bell notification so you get a notification every time I upload. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye.